Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
It is Monday, my friends. Thank you for joining us, the 14th day of May, 2012. And Lord willing, we're going to be here live for the next 3 hours. The former Navy SEAL and one of the top hand-to-hand combat trainers in the country, who was banned from entering England to teach the population self-defense because a criminal state does not want its slaves knowing how to defend themselves, only wants special paramilitary units that know how to defend themselves and abuse the population. Tim Larken, training so evil, it's banned in the UK. He will be, I mean that sarcastically, victim disarmament is what's evil. You see, I don't even need a firearm to get a firearm. It's the old joke of the ball peen hammer or butter knife brigade. But and I'm not even the toughest guy around, but I am willing to defend myself. I am willing to kill people with my bare hands. It's not very hard to do, by the way. Tim Larken, he's going to be joining us coming up in the second hour today. Banned in the UK. We're going to be discussing that with him coming up. Also, all over the United States, and we've been reporting on this the last few months, but now it's getting attention even in the Hill newspaper. Why is the Obama administration allowing the Chinese government to buy up U.S. oil and gas deposits worth billions of dollars while passing regulations selectively to harass U.S. developers, I should add? And that dovetails with lawmakers largely silent over Chinese takeover of U.S. bank branches. In fact, the headlines, lawmakers stay largely silent over Chinese takeover of U.S. bank branches. And we're going to be discussing globalism, how it's designed to destroy a country's national sovereignty and how that's happening right now in our precious republic. A true witch, Dianne Feinstein, the so-called senator who will never leave. Imagine someday when she dies, it'll be like Lenin's tomb and she'll still be the senator ruling California from hell, from the Ninth Circle. Feinstein, get ready for more aggressive molestation at the airport. She says, I know the American people are mad. Well, you're not going to do jack squat. Because if they can stick their hands down your pants, they can do anything. This is about total federalization and annihilation of the Fourth Amendment. But it integrates in with real security threats that they say aren't an issue. 49 headless corpses found in northern Mexico. Just a few weeks ago, it was 30-something on the U.S. side. I mean, this is a weekly occurrence. Last time I checked, now it's over 50,000 dead in the last 3 years. 70-something thousand dead the last five. I mean, this is a imploded society, which is what the globalists like. Again, the Soviets did that everywhere they took over. It's about wrecking society. They do this on purpose. But it's okay. We've got to give our rights up because Al-Qaeda is so scary. Coming up, Al-Qaeda rebel pictured with UN observers in Syria. And they've had the U.S. ambassador to the UN say last week, listen, there's going to be more bombings, Assad, till you let us take over. The freedom fighters will get you. And they go on to admit the groups blowing up police stations and military bases and shopping malls is Al-Qaeda, and they mass in Jordan and other areas at U.S. bases, and then they just pour across and murder everybody, and Anderson Cooper gets up there all breathless in his ninny, little breathless, pillow-biting way, and little CIA agent he is on record, and he goes, oh, freedom fighters, but I'm supposed to give up all my rights for your freedom fighters. I mean, they have such disdain for us that Feinstein says they're going to grope your little girls and boys regardless. She's going to break America's will because of Al-Qaeda, because they're such a threat, but then Al-Qaeda openly works for them, the dirtbag terrorists that have hijacked our country.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison.
is Monday, the 14th day of May 2012. I am your host, Alex Jones. I'm going to plunge directly into the news and tell you about the guests we've got coming up. Also, we're going to have a jam-packed third hour. We're going to play a clip from arguably the biggest television show in the UK that I was on. They played a clip of my nightly news broadcast, InfoWars Nightly News, that airs every weeknight at 7 o'clock Central. The show is called 8 out of 10 Cats, and Hasselhoff was on the show and made some comments about it. We've had to edit out the cuss words. But that is coming up. And the reason I'm going to air this coming up in the third hour is it's a perfect example of how they take what the TSA is doing, groping people and abusing them, and turn it around on me like I'm the bad guy and make a big joke out of it. And this is how our society is turning into a tyranny, is that everything is now a big joke. And I understand it's a comedy show, but they edited it to make it sound like I'm not going to be at a park groping on women. I'm not attracted to that. I'm not into that. Pointing out that I wouldn't want a job as a TSA agent. Only people that like the raw exercise of power, only people that have something fundamentally wrong with them would want to be pulling people's babies' diapers off and pulling colostomy bags off people and groping women's breasts. This is a joke. And it's all based on the false threat of a manufactured Al-Qaeda threat that is publicly working for the globalist. That's not debated. And we have some news on that today. Al-Qaeda rebel pictured with UN observers in Syria, and the West and the U.S. ambassador to the UN says, step down Assad or Al-Qaeda will continue to blow up your police stations. They are freedom fighters. I mean, I call it like a magical skeleton key. We've got to give up all of our rights because of Al-Qaeda. Kills less people every year, even if it was real, than honeybee stings or water moccasin bites or rattlesnake bites or birds flying into windshields and causing wrecks or deer. Look the numbers up. Hundreds killed by deer a year. It's over 200 on average. Hundreds killed by honeybees. Hundreds by red wasp. Hundreds by yellow jackets per species. Hundreds by brown recluse. Hundreds by black widow. Hundreds by rattlesnakes, hundreds by on and on and on. Not even hundreds a year by Al-Qaeda. And then Al-Qaeda publicly is a creation of the globalists, the CIA, and is used to menace the West and take our liberties. And they use Al-Qaeda to take over Libya, now Syria, and it's on the news. And the U.S. ambassador to the UN, Rice, said last Friday, step down Assad or there'll be more bombings. And I listen to NPR, and it's like, the freedom fighters bomb some more police stations. And the freedom fighters wear Al-Qaeda uniforms with the Al-Qaeda patch. All right, I'm already digressing. That's in the stack, Infowars.com. Al-Qaeda rebel pictured with UN observers in Syria. This is even in French news agency AFP. That's where the photo comes from. But again, I've got to... As I guess I drive on the highway now, because they're training the police to do this, have them grope my wife and children. Again, getting in our space, prisoner training, that's all this is, where I'm a terrorist because of Al-Qaeda, while they work for the West. And then the biggest show in the UK, 8 out of 10 Cats, makes a joke out of it. And I'm told some of the people inside the thing are fans. In fact, somebody I even know, I guess, works there. And so this is their way of at least getting the point out. And Hasselhoff and the others get a big laugh out of it. But it's not funny. It's not funny. So we're going to be airing that. Now, this is a case of censorship. We played this a week and a half ago on the nightly news when the video first got released, and YouTube banned the video. They blocked it. Now, ABC News could show clips. Russia Today could show clips because they're media. But, you know, my show on XM and over 100 AM and FMs and award-winning Project Censor Award, you name it, we're not news because they say. Just like we're delisted from Google News. If you click the news section, we didn't used to be, we are now. and the monolith that they now admit works for the NSA and the CIA and was a creation. Oh, that's been declassified last week completely. That it's totally a government front for private individuals to make money while they spy on us illegally. They hack your computers. They hack your passcodes. Google is the private global government. It's above NSA. That's why we're delisted from Google News and more being knocked down in ranking in the Google listings, which basically is the internet for all intents and purposes on Google Web or Google Everything, as they call it. Doesn't matter. We're still growing by leaps and bounds. But this is the attempt to curtail what we're doing because we'll talk about that. But anybody that tries to post the video of Kelly Thomas being beaten to death over 10 minutes by the police while they pin him down and enjoy for no reason, tasering, crushing his windpipe, smashing his skull in, breaking his jaw, crushing his ribs, crushing his organs. They continue to beat, you know, even after he's there on the ground, a pool of blood, they just stomp for fun, knee kick into the neck, and they get off on it and make jokes after they've basically killed him. Took him a few days to die. This is what cowards do. They go sign up now so they can pull your wife over and rape her on the side of the highway. Got news of that. So they can beat you up. They never get enough exercising power. Not all police, not the old line police. There were always some problems. But now this is the system. This is what they want. This is what they get. And YouTube blocks this video. They either remove it or they block it, kind of like the video we showed that hundreds of news agencies showed of the military in the helicopter shooting Reuters reporters and blowing up vans full of children in the middle of Baghdad. And the helicopter pilots make jokes about it. But then I show the ground troops coming over who are in the real world and picking up the little girls and saving them. And you hear the troops with tears in their voice. I was showing the difference between people that actually have to see the death. And that's what Kurt Vonnegut talked about. He was on the ground under the bombing as a POW in Germany, Slaughterhouse 5, versus the guys in the helicopters who were dehumanizing the people down there on the ground. And I was making the points of how much do drones dehumanize us. So because it was a powerful piece of information, it didn't attack the military. It showed how they're being dehumanized as well. So they would think they banned that video and said that they were looking at banning our channel. We had a huge protest. They put it back up. Well, listen, I have PrisonPlanet.tv, and I have my syndicated radio show, so that as the internet gets censored, we've got other legs to stand on. Doesn't mean they won't chop those down as well, but we've got more than one leg we're standing on. We're going to air the news report we aired Friday on the nightly news, titled Police Hunt Man for Sport, and that's what it is. They've got a lot of famous police tapes. That's why they're now going to federally controlled systems where the scanners can't pick it up or it's scrambled. And it's like, let's go out hunting tonight. They don't go out and hunt wild boar. They don't go out and hunt pheasant. They don't go out and hunt white-tailed deer, mule. They go out and they hunt people. And, you know, be careful you don't stare into the abyss lest you become the abyss. I understand that the society's degenerated. I understand there's a lot of slobs and trash, the trashification, the wussification, the scumification of America. It's not just the police turning into scum, the general public. So I wouldn't want your job in a million years, but it doesn't matter. You sign on for it, you're going to follow the Bill of Rights and Constitution. Everybody knows Guatemala's got thug police. Everybody knows North Korea's got thug police. Everybody knows China's got thug police. So why is it then bad if I say what the founding fathers said and said, hey, we better keep government on a short leash? It's the number one threat to liberty, to family, to society. That's what I'm talking about. That's what America's based on. And the fact that they have all these handbooks and training manuals and training videos that we've gotten over the years from good police and shown you, where they talk about, you criticize the police state, you criticize warrantless searches, you're a terrorist. You like Ron Paul, you're a terrorist. You're a returning veteran who had